Dear students of standard 11, welcome to my physics class. Now I will calculate electric field intensity at a point near a insulating charge in finite sheet by applying Gauss's law. Look everybody, here it is an infinite sheet of insulating material and some charges, positive charge, are distributed on its surface. So you have to remember one point. If I distribute some charge on a insulating sheet, then what will happen? The charge will reside on both sides of the sheet. That means you are seeing the frontal part of the sheet. On this portion, some charges will be distributed, and in the backward portion that you can see, okay, in that portion also some charges will be distributed. And we have to find out the electric field intensity at a point that is very near to the sheet. Look, we will find out the electric field intensity, suppose at this point. Okay. So I have written here infinite sheet. So I think the question can arise in your mind. Infinite sheet, that means the sheet has no limit, isn't it? No starting, no ending. It is infinite, its size is infinity. Not like that. Why I have written here infinite? Because this distance, the distance at which I will find out the electric field intensity, is very, very less than the size of the sheet. That's why it is written as infinite sheet. So here, if I want to find out the electric field intensity at that point, that is very nearer to the sheet, I have to consider what? I have to consider a Gaussian surface. Okay? You know, Gaussian surface is symmetric, and the electric field intensity at every point on the Gaussian surface is equal, have the same magnitude. Now, the Gaussian surface is punched into the sheet like this way. Okay? Look everybody, I have already made for you, I have made one example for that. Suppose this is the infinite sheet and this is the Gaussian surface, cylindrical Gaussian surface, and this is the direction of the electric field intensity. Look, the electric field intensity are parallel to each other and they are perpendicularly outward from the sheet. And as I said, there is charge in both portion of the sheet. So the so in the frontal part, the electric field intensity is out perpendicularly outward, and in the back part also the electric field intensity is perpendicularly outward. Okay. Look. So in this series, cylindrical Gaussian surface, you can see it has three surfaces. Okay, this frontal, this flat part, this flat part, and this curved portion of the cylindrical Gaussian surface. So if I want to calculate flux, then I have to consider these three surfaces. Okay, this is surface 1, this is the surface 1, and if I consider to calculate flux, then this is the area vector. If I consider this very small area, okay, so the direction of the area vector and the direction of the electric field intensity will be along the same direction. And in surface 2 also, the direction of the area vector and the direction of the electric field intensity will be along the same direction. That means theta is 0 degree in this surface and also in that surface. But if I consider any point on the curved portion of the cylindrical Gaussian surface, then you know the direction of the surface vector is always towards u. So if you want to see this surface area from here, then the direction of this surface area will be along u, towards u, perpendicularly outward. And as I have already shown, the electric field intensity
is everywhere parallel to each other and perpendicularly outward. So here electric field intensity and the area vector has an angle that is 90 degree. So if I want to calculate flux of this Gaussian surface, I have to calculate flux in these three surfaces. That means flux phi equal to phi 1 plus phi 2 plus phi 3. Okay. So phi equal to phi 1 plus phi 2 plus phi 3. That is for the three surfaces. Look everybody, the charge density of the sheet is sigma. Charge density means charge per unit area. And the charge that is enclosed by the Gaussian surface. Okay, look, this Gaussian surface, okay, is Q. So sigma equal to, you can write sigma equal to Q by A. That means charge per unit area. So now in the surface one, the flux is closed surface integration of E dot ds. In surface 2, closed surface integration of E dot ds. In surface 3, also E dot ds. Look everybody, in surface 1 and in surface 2, theta equal to 0 degree. Okay, so cos theta value is 0 degree, then it is equal to 1. But in the surface 3, theta equal to 90 degree. So there, cos theta will be 0. So we will not get any value from here. From these two, we can calculate the total flux of the Gaussian surface. E will be taken out of the integration sign. E integration of ds and E integration of ds. If I integrate ds, I will get the surface area. Ea plus Ea. I will get twice Ea. Look, phi equal to what? From Gauss's law, you get phi equal to Q by epsilon naught. So in place of phi, I can write Q by epsilon naught. Here I get the value of phi twice Ea. So twice Ea equal to Q by epsilon naught. But E from here, I can find out the value of E. E equal to Q by 2 epsilon naught A. In place of Q by A. In place of Q by A, I can write sigma. That is the charge density, charge per unit area. So my final equation comes E equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. That means by this equation we can calculate the electric field intensity at a very point, at a very point that is nearer to a infinite charge sheet. Have you understood everybody? If you have any problem in understanding, you can message to me. So goodbye everybody.